I'm going to try parking somewhere new tonight. This is Basingstoke Canal Car Park in Odiham. Expensive pint now, £5.88. Oh, that's a very nice posh loo. Yeah, it wants to be as well. Ah, look at that, the seat's coming off. I paid nearly £6 for the privilege of this. Excuse me. Walk back to the boat, I mean the car. There's the old Crowley sign. Alistair Crowley's dad. Nissan Figaro. Little out of the way table. It's getting a bit chilly tonight. I'll sit down here for a minute. Right. Good morning. It's about 5:15 in the morning. I slept like a bloody log last night. I must have crashed out quite early after eating. Must have been about 10. No later than 10:30, but if you remember, I didn't sleep much the night before up at Kingsclere. So I was a little bit overdrawn in the sleep bank. And I reckon I've had 6 or 7 hours straight through, which is a lot for me. I normally only do about 4, 5. So, yeah, great night's sleep. It's Sunday morning, 24th of July. Temperature in the cabin is 23.4 degrees centigrade.
I've just been watching a couple of episodes of Amy in a Van. First, I watched the one where she did a 1.5 year build of her van, condensed into 20 minutes or so. And she does everything. It's pretty amazing. And then I've just watched her solo van life in London. Wow. Some people have got all the talent, all the brains, all the beauty, all the luck. That's all I can say. I'd like to emulate her style. So, so this is my van. I built it all myself. I put the rope in at the top, the bungee. I hung a bulb from it. I put some fly screens and tints on the rear windows. I put a blanket up over the bungee and the seats by the screen. There's a toolbox. There is a box with a load of crap in it. And below that is the auxiliary crap. What have we got? There's a fan down there. Well, let's go the other way. Got some speakers on the shelf, kettle, radio, cup, got some pincers. There's a light up there. Torch here, actually. My feet are down here. And there's a box of food down there. And my fold-up table and chairs are stored down there. I don't think you can really see. Look, there's my feet.
Oh, hang on. Look at the light.
So yeah,
there we go. I'm fairly comfortable, really.
There's a four-way mains extension down there. If you look out the front, there's my guitar, some spare clothes, toiletries bag, day pack, various bits and pieces, another extension on the dashboard. I can't see what I'm filming. And there's just a bag I chucked onto the front seat. I'm blind. I've already had a wee this morning. And I've over half filled my bottle, so I quite fancy another one, but I don't want to risk not having enough room in the bottle, so I'm holding on to it for the moment. I've got another bottle somewhere, but I can't find anything. I am getting slowly more organised, but I'm not there yet. I've still got too much crap I don't need, I suspect. The
and I'm always losing things. Not being able to find a spoon or a knife when I need it. And yesterday, I thought I was driving around with the cool box on. It wasn't plugged in properly, so it wasn't getting any of the benefit from cooling. So I'm a little hungry. But I'm not sure about the bacon now, because it's been in the cool box. Let me see. I can't even think now. Probably since Wednesday. With no cooling. I might give it a sniff and see if it's okay, because it is smoked. Been pretty much since I've been doing this. I don't think I've woken up once with the car wet with rain. It's, I think every night it's been dry. I've not been able to cook outside because it's been raining once. in a way, I'm kind of looking forward to that challenge. People ask me why I'm doing this, and it's hard to say really. In an ideal world, I'd own a nice country house and a little bit of land, or failing that, I might live in a narrowboat. Failing that, I'd live in an RV or a camper van. But those aren't options on the table for me at the moment. I'm pretty skint. And I make just enough to get by, really. If anything goes wrong with the car, well, I've got a problem. But it's a journey, I suppose. Just something I feel I need to do. I mean, I do absolutely love driving around and seeing England. Not that I'm seeing much of it, but Hampshire itself is just some beautiful places. And I will get out in the future and do more. Go to Dorset, Surrey, Berkshire, Oxfordshire, Devon, Yorkshire, Somerset. I did it a couple of years ago, but I stayed in hotels. Yeah, I wish I'd bought a camper. I was mad. Yeah, it was a really good opportunity to kind of get my life on track.
but it was falling apart at the time. So, I got married in 2019, and it was an amazing wedding, beautiful day, and I was very happy. Well, we got married in September in 2019, and I moved out in June 2020. So, 9 months married life, and it's pretty devastating. I think I'm just about getting over it. It's still hard sometimes, but hey ho. What doesn't kill us makes us stronger. As you can see, I'm smoking in my car. I don't care. But I do care. I just watched a video about car life improving your mental health. And I do feel that's true. Obviously I'm not quite there yet because I'm still smoking. And I've smoked loads of fags this morning already. And I'm a big procrastinator. It takes me ages to get things done. Think about things for a long time before doing them. And I need to change these things. So, my challenge is, can I give up smoking, living car life? Never give up. I've been low before, but I'm pretty happy guy, really. Frustrated, maybe. Frustrated. I'm frustrated with myself sometimes. But I'm pretty laid back and I'm pretty content with the world. And perhaps it's my sort of contentness that makes me lazy. Why do I keep losing things? I've been accused of being on a downward spiral by living in my car by a friend. My mum keeps asking me if I'm happy, which is worrying. And when I say I am, she says, or are you just trying to convince yourself that you are? And I say, there's no answer to that, is there? I'm pretty happy now. Be happier when my bladder's empty and I've got a nice cup of coffee, but no one's going to do it for me. I've got to do it for myself. So let's spring into action. Right, let's see what we can do before we actually have to get out of the car.
Well, there's quite a few cars parked in this car park this morning. There's a box of crap. What I'm looking for is not in there. It's not in there. Let's put the radio on. Some bowls which I have used, which I need to wash up, just being white. I've got a bag for my sunshade, which I don't know if I need to keep really. And I've got some scrubbies, two little containers which I haven't utilised yet. I'll throw them down there. Aha! I've just spotted. I can have a wee in that. Oh, found what I'm looking for. I've got some bird seed for the birds, which I haven't given any yet. Some sunnies. This is just all cracked in here. Some cables. A pouch. Spatula. Okay. In the car park. Am I going to have a wee? My knife. Trying to reach the bin. Jammed in there. I'll just put that there. I can go in the bin later and I can access it. My hook's just fallen down. That always falls down. I haven't really used it yet, but I thought with the things on it, it could be useful for something. Let's have a look out the windows. There's an officious looking man in a high-vis jacket and a white helmet over there. I don't know whether he's a hobby bobby or water bailiff or something like that. He's chatting to one of the men in cars over there. Anyway. Maybe checking for fishing licenses or boating licenses or something like that. So we'll hold off on the wee for the moment. And we'll prepare my coffee pot in here before I go outside. Alright. No. That's a toilet roll. I've got a roll of bags here somewhere. Yeah. Absolutely no point in doing it because there's water in the bottom of that and I need to tip it somewhere. Okay, plan B. Right, I'm getting into the front, putting on my trainers, then making my coffee and brushing my hair. Put some sounds on. Oh. Copyright strike. I don't even like this song. What else have we got? Well, I was about to get my table and my stove out and cook up coffee, but it's quite early and this car park's getting round very early. I think either there's some activity or just because it's a nice sunny day, people want to get out and do stuff. So, rather than take up extra space, and I'm just going to find somewhere nice, have a little drive around and find somewhere nice to brew up, make some breakfast. Yeah, actually, I could go and get some fresh bacon and bread from Sherfield on Lollan. Well, actually, I wonder what's in Odium. If there's anything to buy in Odium, I'll have a look. I'll have a look in Odium, see if there's a butcher open. If not, could try Sherfield on Lollan. Could try Newlands Farm Shop, actually. Yeah, get some good bacon from there. Okay, what am I doing? I think I'm going to Newlands. They'll have Lou's there. They've got Lou's there. That's a plan. See you soon. Right, well, I've been to the farm shop. Got myself four rashers of smoked bacon. Smoked streaky for £1.25. And two Smoky Joe sausages for £1.85. Which surprised me for two sausages, but there we go. Now, and I've had a wee, so it was quite busy in there. Let's go and find somewhere to make breakfast. That's pinging sound. It's my seatbelt indicators. My seatbelt's not on. As you can see, it is. It's always done that. It's always been a... goes off after a couple of minutes usually. So I'm getting low on petrol again. Got about 60 miles left in the tank. I'm gonna have enough money to put a whole tank of petrol in. And I tend to think in miles, so So I tend to think about 40 miles for every £10 I put in. Though the price of petrol's gone up quite a lot in the past few months, that figure hasn't really changed. Reason being, my driving style has. I am much lighter on my foot these days. I used to tear around quite a bit, but I'm so conscious of how expensive petrol is now. If I was driving like I used to drive, I guess I'd be getting about 30 miles to a tenner. But I can, even with petrol at £1.90, I can still pretty much count. Oh, little sparrows, get out of the way. Car behind me probably thinks, what the hell's he slowing down for? That's a beautiful farmhouse. I'm doing 40 at the moment, which is faster than I really want to be. Someone up the backside, so can't be too much of a dick about it. I may pull over for him in a second, because obviously everyone's in such a huge rush, and I know, I get it. I used to be the person in a huge rush. Partridges in the road, slow down for them.
Stuttery.
Picked mushrooms in that field before. Nice quiet little lane. No tipping, which I see some people haven't paid any attention to. So I'm going to sit up here. There's a lovely field of corn over there. Can't beat the first coffee of the day. That's the second egg I've broken this morning. Where did you go? You've just missed breakfast. It was lovely. I had two fried egg sandwich. If you'd been here, I'd have done you something. Never mind. I'm on my second cup of coffee now. It was so good, the first one. I had to have another proper coffee. Actually, as cheap as anything, I bought this ground coffee from Poundland for £1. And it tastes absolutely lovely. They've got two varieties, a dark roast and a medium roast. I think I'm preferring the medium roast, but they're both very good. Now, I'm parked in a lay-by here. Well, it's not a lay-by, it's just a little spot. on the side of a country lane. It says no tipping. Now, I'll just turn. As you can see, there's a little bit of litter. So, I'm not going to go mad, but I'm just going to pick up the worst of it, just to improve it slightly. And I reckon it's a good tip for any of you fellow car lifers, van lifers. It only takes a couple of minutes to pick up a bit of litter. You can wash your hands after, or you can get one of these litter picking sticks. Then you're actually doing some good when you go round to places and park up. So yeah, why not? It's pretty disgusting. So yeah, just pick up a bit of litter. Someone else just pulled in. Two bags full. Not perfect. A lot better than that is. If we could all just do that, the countryside would be more pleasant. When you're going for a walk through the woods, take a bag with you to pick up other people's rubbish. Or anywhere in the country. Because you didn't drop it, you can actually have a positive effect. So there you go. The lay-by looks a bit better now. Let's keep an eye on this and see how much more rubbish there is next time I come back to this spot.